Beauty in the building, and I'm back with another video. If you guys are new to my channel, tap that subscribe button so that you won't miss out on any of my new uploads. And if you have already subscribed, what's good? What's poppin'? Welcome back to my channel. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Miss Unique Beauty. I went ahead and did my braid pattern off camera already. I did 40 individual braids in the front, and I did 5 cornrows going straight back in the back portion of my head. And I will explain to you guys later on in the video why I chose to go with this braid pattern. The hair in today's video was sent to me by a company called ZRQ Store on Amazon, and they were kind enough to send me their 36-inch new locks in the color 350. Now, I am going ahead and unpackaging this hair for you guys so that you guys can see how it comes. It does come in this cute little backpack, and in the backpack was 4 packs of hair, some rubber bands, and a crochet hook. Now, I also went ahead and purchased some spring twist hair with my own money on Amazon as well in the color 350 to go ahead and wrap my roots with that as well. Now, this is what the locks are looking like straight out of the pack. And when I tell you these locks are super duper long, these locks are extremely long. But what I will say about these locks is that even though they are extremely long, they are very lightweight, which is why everyone loves these 36-inch new locks. So you still get that long style, but the locks are extremely lightweight. Now, this is the spring twist hair. I did go ahead and pre-fluff all of the spring twist hair that I needed, and I went ahead and hung it on my braiding rack just to make it easier for me to apply them to my head. Now, right here is just a quick demonstration showing you guys how I pre-fluffed the hair, and all I went ahead and did was separate the strands, and that was pretty much it. I separated the strands all along the entire strand of hair, and that was pretty much it. Now, for crocheting these locks, I am gonna go ahead and crochet each lock in each individual section that I created in the front, and I am only bringing the lock through the loop. I'm not bringing my hair through the loop. Reason being is because I will be wrapping the roots of my hair anyways, so there is no need to pass my hair through that lock. Now, once I get that spring twist hair crocheted on, I am gonna go ahead and begin wrapping the roots of the lock all the way down to where the spring twist hair ends. Now, this is gonna reach way past my hair. If you guys want, you guys can stop where your hair ends, but I just decided to go all the way down the length of the lock. Now, one thing I will say that when using any type of colored locks and doing this method, your hair, if it's not the same as the lock, may peek through a little bit. Now, if you were to use the color 1 or the color 1B in the soft locks, your hair will blend so much better with the soft locks than it would if with any other colored locks. Now, I did not mind my hair peeking through the locks. I kind of felt like it gave my hair a little bit more dimension, but that is something to keep in mind if you guys do decide to go with using a colored lock. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate this process one more time. I am passing the crochet hook through the base of my single braid, then I'm going to crochet that lock to the base. Then I'm gonna go in and crochet that spring twist hair to the base as well, and begin twisting that spring twist down the length of the lock until the spring twist is no longer there. Now I am on my last lock installation. Now one thing that I will say is that this process does take some time. So if you guys are in a rush, I suggest not doing this method. If you have enough time to spare before, you know, your trip or before you have to go somewhere, then you guys can do this method. I will say that I absolutely love the individual method a lot better than the crochet method because it looks a lot more natural. But if you guys do not want to spend so much time installing them individually, you guys can go ahead and just crochet them into your cornrows that you create going straight back. Now, I did go ahead and do half my head in individuals. My intentions was to do my entire head in individuals, but I realized this process was taking a really long time, so I then decided to just go ahead and crochet the back section. Now, this is what the front section of my hair is looking like after I completely did the individual method in the entire front section of my head. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and put the front section up in a bun to make it easier for me to work in the back section of my head. I did go ahead and use a total of 40 strands in the front section of my head, so the remainder of the hair, I will be using all of it to fill in this entire back section of my head. So I am gonna go ahead and crochet this back section on camera for you guys so that you guys can see exactly how I place each of the locks and exactly how I conceal the back section of the hair just to make it look nice and natural, just like the front section. Now, crocheting these locks were super duper simple and I had absolutely no issues crocheting these locks in the back. All I did was push my crochet hook underneath my cornrow. I put the loop to the lock on the hook of the cornrow, pulled the lock through my cornrow. Then I did go ahead and attach the end of the lock on the hook and pulled that through the loop and tightly secured the lock onto the base of my cornrow. Super simple, super easy, just like any other crochet style that I have done. Now, for the back section, because, you know, they are cornrows, you want to make sure that you are crocheting them in a way that you don't see any gaps in the back section of your head. So what I will be doing is I will be connecting the cornrows by crocheting a lock in between two cornrows. I really hope that I explained that correctly, but that's how I get the back section to look as natural as possible to where you don't see any gaps in the back section of my head. Now, what I will say is that these locks do come in a bunch of different colors, so there is a variety and a color for everybody. So you can get these locks in a natural color 1B, you can get them in a color 30, a color 27, 613, 350. You could even do a mixture of the colors together to make your own style. So don't be afraid to try some color. I absolutely love trying color, which is why I chose this 350 color. And I absolutely loved how this style came out. So I'm gonna go ahead and just have you guys finish watching me install the locks in this back section. Then I'm gonna come back and show you guys the finished results of what these locks are looking like completely installed. Oh. This is what this back section is looking like after I went ahead and installed all of the locks in the back section. Now I'm going to go ahead and do my slow-mo for you guys so that you guys can get into the everything about this hair. Now I'm going to go in with my Style Factor Edge Booster Pomade to smooth my edges and create some baby hairs in the front section of my head. And I rave about this product in just about all of my videos, and I absolutely swear by this product. This product leaves my edges down all day long. I have no complaints with this product. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my edges for you guys, and then this style is pretty much complete. I am gonna go ahead and show you guys a few ways that you can style these locks when wearing them on a daily basis, and that's pretty much it. Now this first style is my favorite style to wear my hair in, which is a half up, half down ponytail style. I really love wearing my hair in this style, and I pretty much wear my hair like this just about every single day I have these locks in. This next style is also super easy to achieve. It's basically just a top knot bun. All I did was go ahead and wrap the ends of the ponytail around into a bun, and this is style number two. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the link to this hair in the description box down below so that you guys can go ahead and check it out. Remember, you guys do not have to get this color. If you guys don't want this color, you guys can also choose from an array of other different colors they do have as well. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Comment down below any suggestions or questions that you guys may have. Smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Bye, my beauty.